75th anniversary. I mean, it's the first time they've put Division III, Division II, Division I together. I think it's a tremendous opportunity for, you know, small college basketball to be a part of the big show, if you will.
It's still almost an awe to be here, you know, with all the people. You know, all the people are looking at us like, you know, we're the superstars and everything. It's change of pace for us.
Be able to take part in the 75th celebration of March Madness and to have both Division II and III taking part in the Final Four, one of America's great sporting events. It's just been a really, really special week for these kids.
Echo!
I think it gives the smaller schools a little bit more exposure. You know, you kind of live like a D1 player for a week.
Our team is one of a kind. I've never been a part of a team like this. Last year we made it to the Elite Eight. We have 9 guys returning from that team.
That's what's unusual about our team is the chemistry, you know, and to be honest with you, when we face adversity, these guys seem to bond even more.
You know, taking part in the salute presentation and you know, some of the guys were playing air hockey and other things against, you know, Louisville and Syracuse players. I mean, it's just a really, really neat thing.
It was an amazing experience, you know, not just for the starting five, but for the whole team. You know, our roster goes deeper than 8 players that usually play on a regular basis. It shows that all 13 players matter and are the reason why we're here today.
And getting to touch the game ball before the game that can start, so let us know that we're playing for something special here.
And the concerns on the Division II and III side of things were, it's such a big event anyway, do our student athletes and teams get lost in the shuffle with all that's going on? And I give a lot of credit to the NCAA staff, the Division I Men's Basketball Committee, and all those people involved in really making our student athletes feel appreciated and recognized for their accomplishments for getting here. And it's been a wonderful experience, I think, for all of our student athletes and families and coaches and everybody.
Being a part of it, being a part of the Final Four instead of watching it at home like you do every year, you know, it's something special that, you know, not many people will get a chance to be a part of.
It was just awesome that we get to sit here and watch the game. Then we got to go down and get introduced at halftime. And like, I don't know about the other guys, but I was just on my phone. I was like, oh.
I think that's one of our strengths, you know. We can enjoy everything, have fun, have a good time, but when it's time to play, it's time to play and time to go to work.
We're really just trying to stay focused, go through our same routine as every game, and just be ready for the game.
Kids being around, I think we give them a great example of what it takes to be a college athlete. And I don't think they understand that that much. And we show them that it really is, you know, it's helpful that we're good in the classroom as well as on the court.
I'm extremely proud of where we are right now and playing in the national championship game. I'm going to get the same satisfaction knowing that our 4 seniors are going to have an opportunity to graduate this summer. I'm as proud as that as whatever happens on Sunday in this national championship game, because really that is the mission of what we're supposed to do, is move these guys forward.
Yeah, we came out a little sluggish and they definitely got the jump on us, and we weren't playing well, we weren't playing together very well.
Metro State really forcing them to work on the defensive end of the floor too.
And at halftime, coach is just like, we gotta get back to being us.
Got the tempo up a little bit, made some plays defensively. Some guys stepped up, made some big shots, and you know, we still couldn't get over the hump, and you know, just finished the last 4 minutes of the game and held them scoreless. And then we did a tremendous job the last possession of limiting them to a really tough shot.
The buzzer, Jefferson, it's all over! Troy University!
And the refs called it. We just rushed the court and we just went ballistic. It was the best moment of my life, almost.
The best part was either, you know, turn around and see my whole team run towards us. That, or, you know, seeing the look on my family's face when I look in the crowd. You know, they've never missed a game.
I think it's really life-changing for some players. And this experience, you know, we remember this for the rest of our lives.